Previously on Hell's Kitchen.
Let's go, guys.
Chef Ramsay tested the final four at the pass.
Tommy, talk to me!
Don't interrupt me and I'll fucking tell you.
Can you take that back and give me a beef and not a lamb?
Good, well spotted.
It looks like it's been chewed by your dog!
And while Tommy worked on convincing himself he did well enough...
I didn't think I did bad. Do you think I did that bad?
Tough crowd.
Elise was sure she did enough to make it to the final two.
Elise, I got respect for you because you're a tough chick and you want what you want.
He feels that I did a good enough job tonight to make it to the finals, and he's scared.
But Chef Ramsay knew who his final two were and eliminated
Tommy.
Bang up job, kid.
And
Elise, do you know what? Keep your jacket. You deserve it.
Thank you.
Tonight, the matchup we've all been waiting for.
It's totally 100% game on.
From the beginning, Paul's passion to find him.
Hustle, I'm tired of getting my ass kicked.
And despite some early setbacks.
New office.
Fuck, it's embarrassing.
Paul only got stronger.
You win the challenge. Congratulations, well done.
Thank you, Chef.
Dominating the last two individual challenges.
Yes.
Bloody spot on, well done.
Yes. Awesome.
Will established himself as the one to beat early on.
That is delicious. Great job.
I don't worry about somebody eating my food. I do it and I do it right.
And he continued to shine.
You cooked the burger.
Perfect.
All season long.
Oh my gosh. Delish.
Will, you win the challenge.
Well done, brother.
Scores, please. Wow, an almost perfect score. Will, great job.
I said it from day one and I'll say it now. The only one that can beat me is me.
Two worthy competitors.
Come on, guys!
Put it all on the line.
This one's still raw!
Oh, fuck me.
Who will triumph?
Fall to your brigade!
And become the head chef of BLT Steak New York.
I'm not going down without a fight, I can tell you that much.
And the winner of Hell's Kitchen.
This is it! Push, push, push!
Find out. Right now. And now, the conclusion of Hell's Kitchen.
Okay, both of you, listen very carefully. Your biggest service is yet to come.
The chef.
A chef.
Start thinking about the menus, the magic that you want to really show off. Get upstairs and get to work on those menus.
Yes, chef.
Great job.
Don't worry, Will, you can always be my sous chef.
Yeah!
Here comes Big Will.
Ah! You know, like people say it's not real unless you can touch it, man? Well, I can fucking touch it, dude. I can touch it all.
Oh, fuck, man.
I told y'all. Y'all didn't believe me. Paul had a big fucking deal. Pauly final two.
To the experience, to the journey, and to what is to come.
After a brief celebration, the finalists work late into the night, planning their menus for the final dinner service.
I'm in the final two. I'm one service away from completing my goal to becoming a chef in New York City, and it just makes me think of my mom. My mom passed just a few months before I came out here. I know that she's proud of me. She's watching how far I've gotten on this, and I'm not letting myself down, I'm not letting my mom down, I'm not letting anyone down. I'm gonna win this.
I wanna win so badly, man, it's not even funny, because this is what I was born to do. I'm the epitome of what Chef Ramsay is looking for in a chef. And I will do everything in my goddamn power to make sure that I fucking win.
With the work on their menus completed, the finalists spend the morning reviewing their master plan with the sous chefs.
Toasted pecans with a sunny quail egg.
Sounds amazing.
Bronzini, we're gonna cut it the same way that we did before. The one filet will cut it in half.
Talk about old school.
Yeah.
And they spend the afternoon refining their dishes for the most important dinner service of their lives.
How are you, Will? Come here, quickly. Paul, come here, quickly. Okay, I think right now that both you need to relax and de-stress. So I'm going to take you both out for dinner.
Awesome.
There's a limo waiting for you outside. Hurry up.
Thank you, Chef.
Excited about the opportunity to get a break from the intense preparation, Paul and Will quickly change for an evening out with Chef Ramsay.
Gentlemen, congratulations. Your limousines are waiting for you. Will.
Thank you very much.
Holy fucking shit. Are you freaking kidding me?
I opened the freaking limo and it's my mom and my wife. I'm shocked. I'm in awe. I don't really know what to say.
Mom.
Congratulations, baby.
Let's get out of here.
Thank you, James. Hey, guys. Welcome to Blasco.
Thank you very much, Chef.
Hi, Tom. All right, got here a little early. Check out the table. You didn't expect this, did you?
No, Chef. No.
Chef's out of New York. He opened up literally 4 weeks ago.
Really?
Oh, wow.
So he's put together the most amazing menu. Would you like to say hello?
Yes, we'd love to.
Chef Ren's like, let's go see the kitchen. I'm like, all right, cool. Let's go look at the kitchen. Let's go meet another chef.
I'm really excited about this.
So this chef is starting to meet you, and the kitchen is unique.
This ain't no kitchen. Holy shit, I have arrived. There's cute girls everywhere in that crowd. I felt like a culinary rock star.
Can you remember when I told you that you weren't stars?
Yes, Chef.
Now you are. Enjoy the moment.
Come on! Come on!
Now it's time for your final challenge. We'll have 1 hour to prepare 5 stunning dishes that could be on the menu at BLT Steak.
Chef.
Chef.
And your time starts now. Off you go. Wish you good luck.
We're going to cook 5 plates in 1 hour. The only thing in my mind is, what am I going to make?
Let's go, Will and Paul.
Yes, Chef.
For this final challenge, Will and Paul must create their unique take on 5 types of dishes that could appear on the BLT menu. A seafood appetizer, a salad, a seafood entree, a bone-in ribeye, and a fillet of beef.
Gotta go big or go home. I feel my dishes will impress the judges. They are things that I'm very comfortable doing. They're a reflection of how I cook. Very clean, very sleek. Awesome.
30 minutes to go.
Yes, Chef.
Under control, Will.
Chef. I'm not a safe guy. I try not to play life in a safe way.
These beets, we're gonna peel them.
Yeah.
Quarter them out.
I tried to make every dish untraditional and unconventional.
Does that not look like Pepto?
No, it looks hot.
That's just my style, you know what I'm saying?
Start plating up for me, Jess. 15 seconds to go.
Cilantro
off
the truffle crust.
Okay. Chopped cilantro, lemon zest, lemon juice. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and stop. For today's challenge, we have 5 very, very notable judges. They are all part of the BLT family. First up, please welcome the executive chef from BLT in Washington, Chef Victor Albusu. Right, let's start off with Paul. Please describe your dish.
My dish is a seafood naj, little neck clams and mussels with a lemongrass spicy broth. It's finished with a little bit of butter and alamet potatoes on the side.
Oh, this is very well done.
Thank you.
The mussels are clean, really nice. I think this is a very well executed dish.
Thank you, Chef.
Will, please present your dish to Victor. Thank you.
I wanted to keep it on the lighter side. I did seared scallops on a charred corn salad with a corn puree and micro cilantro.
Wow.
Well, these are really well prepared. You have a nice sear on it. The vibrance of the citrus really accents the sweetness of the scallops very, very nicely.
Would you prefer Will's dish or Paul's dish, Victor, please?
I think I'm going to have to go with the scallops.
With Will. Excellent. Please welcome the executive chef at BLT Los Angeles, Chef Brian Moyers.
Will has the early lead, and it's now time for the salad round. Chef Moyers will be deciding between Will's beet salad with champagne vinaigrette.
Beets are cooked well. Could use a little bit more acid.
Okay.
But very nice.
Or Paul's mixed greens over roasted potatoes.
Balanced very well. I love the cheese. I love the vinegar. It's a good salad. itself.
Brian, which one would you choose? Will or Paul's?
Choice is yours.
I'm gonna have to go with you, Paul.
Thank you.
We're all tied up. One to Paul and one to Will. Brilliant.
Judging the fish entrees will be Johan Svensson, chef de cuisine from BLT Honolulu. He will choose between Will's Dover sole.
I would have cooked the fish a little bit less, but in all, it's pretty good.
And Paul's bronzini.
It's crunchy. I like things crunchy, but maybe a little bit softer, so you sort of get the flavors coming out.
Tough decision. Do you prefer Paul's or Will's?
I think we'll go with Chef Paul.
Thank you.
That's two for Paul and one for Will. It's time to move on to the all-important meat rounds. Please welcome the executive chef of BLT New York, Cliff Crooks. Thank you very much.
With Paul only 1 point away from winning the challenge, he hopes to score with his pan-roasted ribeye with buttermilk puree.
Cliff, what do you think?
Extremely eye-appealing. Susan could use a touch more salt and pepper. Other than that, you're right there.
Will, please.
With the challenge on the line, Will needs his grilled ribeye with Gruyere cheese to impress in order to stay alive.
The seasoning is dead on. It's not oversauced. It's spot on.
Spot on.
Spot on.
Wow, Cliff, you got a very tough choice.
Yeah.
Will's in front of you or Paul's?
I'm going to go with Will's.
Will. Wow, we are all tied up, 2-2. Well done. Please welcome, ladies and gentlemen, the president of BLT, Keith Trable.
Good to see you.
Hey, Chef.
Thank you so much for coming.
Oh, my pleasure.
It is 100% the most important thing to impress Keith. This is the boss of the bosses that will be the bosses of me.
Paul, please.
This is my play on steak and frites. I did a pan-roasted filet mignon with a braised endive and truffle potato fries.
This is superb. Not overdone with the truffle. Great balance. Really well done.
Thank you. The flavors were there. Plating on it was beautiful. I mean, he's got to love it, right?
Please, Will, explain your dish to Keith. Thank you.
I did a grilled filet mignon that I served with buttered Brussels sprouts, a black truffle and potato puree, and a red grape jus. It took a set of balls to put grapes on that plate. I'm just hoping that he gets it.
Perfect Brussels sprouts.
Wow, thank you.
I have to say, both of these dishes, excellent.
Is it Will or is it Paul? Please.
I gotta go with Will.
Will. Come on! Yeah!
Representing not only myself, but my entire family, baby. It was probably one of the greatest feelings I've ever experienced in my entire life.
Really, I gotta tell you, bold move with those grapes, my friend. Bold move.
Okay, Will and Paul, great job. Will, congratulations.
Thanks, Chef.
I'd like you both now to head back to Hell's Kitchen, please.
I'm not worried. I'm not shaking. I didn't go out like a punk. And I'm gonna win the service tomorrow. I'm gonna be the next chef at BLT Steak.
When the finalists arrive back at Hell's Kitchen.
Hi, guys.
That's a very large present.
They are greeted by another surprise from Chef Ramsay.
Open now, I want to see what it is.
One, two, three.
That's Tommy's ass. All of the past contestants. And Tommy's ass.
I was definitely happy to see both of them.
Congratulations.
They were my prediction come true, by the way.
Will and Paul, I see you received my final gift.
Yes, Chef.
Welcome back, guys.
Thank you, Chef.
I am like a big present.
This pick is critical. You know their strengths, their weaknesses. Think strategy. Who's gonna work well together? Who's gonna have your back on the most important dinner service of your entire lives? Will, on the back of that win, you get the first pick.
My last page is a list of the 18 competitors we have here with a ranking order. I knew exactly who I wanted from the beginning. First pick, I'm gonna pick Tommy.
Tommy.
Number one draft, baby. I'm not gonna say I'm surprised. I knew I'd be number one pick. Let's get this man some money.
Paul, the first pick.
Come on, Elise.
Elise.
Thank you.
Wow.
Paul feels confident in my ability. He should.
I wouldn't have made that choice first, but whatever.
Will, second pick.
Natalie.
Natalie, wow. Paul, second choice.
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth.
I did leave. I'm pretty angry. You better hope I fucking go home.
I guess you don't like me anymore.
But I never thought in a million years Paul wouldn't pick me.
Hey, hey girl.
Are you going all girl, Paul, or?
Just picking my strengths.
Will, who's it gonna be?
Jimmy Sox.
Wow. Jennifer, great choice.
Smart choice.
If Paul was smart, he would have picked me. But I am very excited that I am not on Elise's team.
Paul, the third choice.
Come on, Jonathan.
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 Will, you're choosing between Carrie and Krupa.
Watch this.
I know that Krupa might not be the best, but I saw Elise on Paul's team, and I saw Carrie still waiting to be picked, so I was like, I'm gonna put the two of them together and hope for some fireworks. Krupa.
You son of a bitch.
You better get out of my face. Hold up, I'm talking.
I'm tired of hearing you talk.
Well, let's toast to not liking each other.
Come on, Carrie.
Thanks, Paul. Appreciate it.
I didn't like Carrie yesterday. I didn't like her the week before that, and I sure don't like her today.
Elise and Carrie. Fuck me.
Paulie is fucked.
Okay, get back up to the dorms and start briefing your teams. Good luck. Off you go, guys.
I'm not totally thrilled about Elise and Carrie being on the same team, but I'm gonna make the best out of what I got. Before this goes any further, all right? If you two fight, I'm gonna put my foot so far up your ass, I'm gonna wiggle my toes, your ears are gonna move, and that's both of you.
I'm not gonna fight with
I'm just saying, I love you both.
I am looking to draw some blood when it comes to this next dinner service for Paul. And that includes beating Carrie's ass after we get out of service if I have to.
I picked the strongest team. I know who I wanted. I got oil and vinegar. I got matches and dynamite.
I'll be honest with you, I really don't know how tomorrow's gonna go.
It's gonna go fine.
Anything that's not self-explanatory, I'm just gonna explain now. You know what I'm saying? So let's start on apps first. Spicy Girl Quell.
Oh, you should be taking notes.
I'm gonna show you exactly how it's gonna end up being broken down.
I need a strong start, and I feel that you can give me the strong start.
I can give you a strong start, but I'm better off working meats.
I know that.
But if you want me to work apps, I will
I
work apps.
I want you to work apps, because that way, when you're done with apps,
I can help whoever.
Like, you're gonna have, like, a wing and a wing.
Oh, God. Will drew a picture of Quill, and it looks like a vagina.
Okay.
Those boobs.
Then Will draws a picture of the thigh and leg, and it looks like a penis.
That is a leg and thigh.
Oh, damn.
Leg and thigh.
So I'm guessing Will is very horny right now and needs to get out of Hell's Kitchen.
It does look like a penis and a big set of balls. I apologize immensely for the way I am drawn.
After a late night preparing their teams for battle, Will and Paul hit the kitchen early to prepare for the biggest dinner service of their lives.
All right, everybody knows what they gotta do, right?
You want the pecans toasted whole, right?
No, I don't. If I had any concern right now, my only concern would be Krupa.
Oh, boiling over. Fuck.
Krupa's the only person in this kitchen I've never worked with. Way too dark.
Too dark?
Way too dark. But it's my job to lead, so I will lead.
Take a handful of those leeks. Blanch them in the hot water, shake them off. This is the most important day in my life. Guys, please fucking hustle for me, please. I cannot fail tonight. I cannot go subpar. I'm gonna lead my team to victory the way that I know how.
It's only an hour before dinner service, and while Chef Ramsay may be confident in his two finalists,
Right, Will, let's go.
He still needs to make sure that all of the dishes are up to his high standards.
Cheese milk nudie with a little shea black truffle, Parmesan broth, and pea greens.
Delicious. I mean, really good indeed. Next.
Spice seared scallops.
Really good.
I'm so confident in my menu. Nobody in this world can tell me that the menu's not good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good start.
Thank you. Definitely think Paul needs to be worried.
Talk me through the menu.
All right. This is my garlic olive oil poached shrimp.
It looks great.
Thank you, Chef. Roasted garlic, some jalapeno, lemons.
Nice.
Thank you, Chef.
Nice, nice, nice. It tastes amazing.
Yes, Chef.
Yeah. Next.
This is my heirloom's tomato carpaccio.
It looks a mess, and, you know, I'm sorry. I've seen plates that have come back with more tomatoes on in Hell's Kitchen, and that's going out.
Yes, Chef.
Yeah? And this is?
The grilled swordfish, chef, with the broccoli rabe, yellow romanesca, and a crab stuffed tomato.
That needs work, urgently. Just dense, boring crab meat.
I told my team exactly what to do, but I didn't taste them and it really fucked me right now.
You got some serious work to do that.
Fuck!
I gotta get out of here.
Tom! I want this not just for myself, but I want this for my mom. I promised my mom that I was gonna win.
Before she died?
Just give me a second. I just want to make her proud. Even though she's not here, she's here in spirit. She's with me always, and she's going to be in the dining room tonight. Guys, up the pass now, please. Whatever you guys had inside of you that got you guys here, I want it tonight.
Good luck. Let's have a good service, y'all. Good service. Good service.
I'm not doing this for my pride. I'm not doing this for fucking fame. I'm doing this because I made a promise to my mom before she died that I was gonna win this. And I need you guys to help me win this. All right?
You got it, Paul.
Let's go.
Everybody ready to rock?
Yeah.
Let's go, boys and girls.
I know, it's like, let's do it.
Tonight's the night, man. This 100% comes down to me. Tonight, I'm gonna prove to Chef exactly why I am here and exactly why I will be hanging on that wall. Let's fucking go.
Okay.
Let's go. I'm not going down without a fight, I can tell you that much.
James.
Yeah, chef.
Let's go. Open Hell's Kitchen, please.
Yeah, chef.
The doors have opened for the final dinner service.
Hell's Kitchen.
Hell's Kitchen.
And with $250,000 on the line and VIP guests filling the dining room,
have a lovely evening, man.
Both Will and Paul are clearly ready to prove to Chef Ramsay why they're worthy of being the next head chef at BLT Steak in New York.
Let's go.
Guys, this is it. First table. 3 risottos, 1 nudie, 1 quail, 1 scallops.
7 minutes.
7 minutes to the window. Thank you.
Natalie's strong on apps. Natalie's a fighter. Natalie's a team player. She's my rock.
You want me to fire some scallops here for you?
No, I've got a pan right here. This is Will's big night. And, you know, I wasn't gonna let him down.
Can I do anything for you, Natalie?
No.
I'm gonna stop asking.
While Will leans on Natalie, over in the blue kitchen...
Order in!
Paul hopes Elise can get appetizers off to a strong start.
Appetizers, 2 shrimp, 2 risotto, entrees, 2 bronzini,
yes,
2 shrimp.
Chef! Come on, you guys, I didn't hear a yes, chef.
Yes, yes, chef.
Guys, talk to me, how long?
2 shrimp, 2 risotto, give me 6 minutes.
6 minutes heard.
I thought that it was gonna be hard for me to come back and help somebody else win, but I'm not bitter, like I wanna see the dude win. Walking with shrimp. Pass, please.
Elise.
What?
There's not supposed to be any stock in there. Just start them again.
I have to keep my cool. I understand working with Elise, I don't wanna frazzle her.
How can we cook a shrimp wrong?
I put a splash of stock in it, it was my bad.
Come on then!
Yes, chef.
First table, and you're cooking it wrong for him. Hurry up, back on the stove, come on! We're live, we're live!
In 45 seconds, we're what the fuck?
Let go! Out of the fucking way.
Oh my God, really? Is it gonna start out like this?
You're a talented cook!
Yes, chef!
Use your brain!
Yes, chef!
While Elise starts over on the first appetizers, over in Will's kitchen...
Nudie, come into the window!
Natalie's first appetizers are already out in the dining room.
Oh my God, so good.
And are being thoroughly enjoyed by customers.
We got the right team.
First entree, stand by. 1 Dover, 1 Bass, 2 New York Strip.
That means get 1 Bass in the oven.
And Will is focused on pushing food out.
Why are they cooking off the fish? I just told her to put it in the oven to start getting it ready.
Understand where you're going, but they haven't even cleared the fucking plate.
Okay.
It's not a race, huh?
Okay.
They get food rammed down their throat. I'm nervous.
While Chef Ramsay tries to keep Will from jumping the gun on entrees, over in the blue kitchen...
Thank you.
Paul is still struggling to catch up on appetizers.
Liz, give me a new scallop. These are overcooked. Make it quick. It's going with a risotto. Please.
Okay.
Hurry up, hurry up.
Come on, Liz, I don't want my risotto dying.
What the hell is going on over here?
I don't know if it was a blonde moment or a dumb moment. It was just an Elizabeth moment.
Scallops, how long?
Yes, I'm walking you on right now.
Thank you.
Liz, Liz, it's undercooked.
Oh, fuck.
Throw it in the oven for another minute.
Yes, chef.
It's 45 minutes into dinner service. And while Elizabeth tries to recover on the fish station, over in the red kitchen.
One bass, one Dover. How long?
2 minutes.
Will is hoping Krupa can deliver on her fish.
That Dover sole must be overcooked by now. Shit.
Yeah.
It's mush.
Do another one.
All right.
Krupa. That's the smell of overcooked fish.
Jen, I need that pushback.
How long?
Give me like 6 minutes.
Ah, oh, Krupa. She was fucking up fish. She had no idea what she was doing. Watching her was like going to the dentist.
Krupa.
Yes.
Slow everything down?
Everything slow down.
While Will tries to recover from Krupa's shaky start on the fish station.
Krupa, you're the one pushing.
Back in the blue kitchen.
Paul, there's nothing going out.
Paul's brigade seems to have lost their momentum.
Abs are out. Let's go. Let's push it. Jonathan, give me this thing.
Jonathan, huh? Do you need help?
No, I'm coming.
Are they ready or not?
Yes.
Walk them with the sauce. This one's still raw.
Oh, fuck me.
Jonathan, come on, man.
Get this shit together. You say you can cook meat. Let's see it.
Don't fucking talk to me like that, man.
Turn around and talk to your fucking brigade.
Come on, man. Seriously.
You're in control. Talk to your brigade here.
Give me the steaks.
Those are raw. If one's raw, they're all raw.
Come on, you guys are killing me. Push.
Put them all in the oven.
Get them all in.
Okay, wait.
What?
Don't throw things.
Fucking fight back. Don't get mad. Jonathan was acting like a little bitch.
Put them all back in the fucking oven. Get them cooking.
I tried to help him, and he wanted to act like a little crybaby. Like, oh, no, I got this. I got this.
Paul, there's nothing going out.
How long you need on those steaks, Jonathan? 2 minutes? Give me an honest number.
3 minutes.
3 minutes. Thank fuck.
There's a lot of thick ones, man.
As Paul tries to keep Jonathan focused on the meat station, over in the red kitchen, Will tries to get Krupa to focus on her fish.
Krupa, how long on a Dover, a bass, a veal, and a New York? A Dover, a bass, a... Guy!
Pay attention!
Dover, bass, veal, and New York. I've got 5 minutes.
Picking Krupa probably wasn't the most intelligent decision.
Oh, my God. Behind. Tess, you should have the sauce still. Yep.
Another minute. Give it another minute in the oven, please. I'm not happy with that. Get off to a great start. Now we've gone deflated. Come on. Do not give up. I want everyone to push until the last kicket is out. Heard?
Heard.
While Will motivates his brigade, over in the blue kitchen, Paul is hoping that Jonathan's steaks...
Two strips.
...are finally the correct temperature.
Elise, get on meat. Jonathan, dude, this is... Again, it's raw, dude. I gotta pull you.
What?
Go help her with garnish. I kicked Jonathan off the station because it got to the point where I had to.
Go help garnish and I'll take over.
I need one strip right now, six all day.
Got you. Jonathan sucks. He can't cook, man. Three strips right now is so high. I only got two. Here, go over there. He said off the meat station.
Man, don't look. Please don't fucking talk to me like that, okay? What really pisses me off is bullshit coming from Elise. Get the bitches out of the kitchen and let me get back on my game.
Listen, don't fight now. I'm not fighting. I'd rather work it by myself.
While Elise begins her rescue of the meat station.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Keep fighting it.
Back on the red side, Krupa is looking to bounce back on the fish station.
Fine. Fish, Dover.
Goo.
Dover, whatever. The first two fish, I fucked up on them.
Little 31.
But I'm not too worried about it. I can definitely, you know, come back from this.
It's undercooked. Let me take that back to the chef.
Oh, thank you.
Oh no, what's wrong?
It's raw.
Undercooked. Well, come on. Fuck me.
Fuck me, bro. Krupa.
Yes, chef.
Reflash this. What? All right. Get that in the oven right now. Reflash it and hurry the fuck up, please. Are you kidding me?
With Will now struggling to get entrees out, over in the blue kitchen...
Let's go! Two shrimp, two bronzini!
Elise is now in complete control of the meat station, and Paul looks to carry for...
Garnish in 30?
Hold on, guys. Garnish in 30?
Do you need help?
45.
Elise,
a minute.
Get on garnish! Honestly, my MVP tonight is Elise.
All right, what are we doing now? Two strip, two bronzini?
She had my back tonight, 100%. I don't care what other people say.
Salt and pepper?
Yeah, babe. I haven't got it quite.
Come on, girl.
Give me the garnish, guys. Come on.
Not yet. She needs 30 seconds.
Hey, honey, I got it. You're really in my way right now, okay? I got this. Seriously, I got it.
No, you don't got it, Carrie. You need help. And Elise to the rescue, as always. Captain Save-A-Ho. He told me to come over here. I'm just doing what he told me to do.
I need the peas and the tendrils.
They're coming right now.
I got it.
Good. I got this. Go.
Still cold.
Okay.
No, they're not. They're hot.
All right, fine.
Peas and pea tendrils.
Thank you.
Yep.
Go.
As Paul's strategic decision to move Elise from station to station pays off.
Oh, is it good?
It's good.
Very good.
Very nice.
Over in the Red Kitchen, in order to turn his kitchen around, Will must make an executive decision of his own.
Natalie!
Yes?
Get on fish, Krupa, get on desserts.
Okay.
All right? I finally had to replace her at the station because there was nothing going. We need to start rolling here. We're starting to slow down. This is not good. We gotta pick it up. Everybody keep pushing, keep fighting.
Can you do something? Can you take that bass up for me?
This one?
Yeah.
What is it supposed to be?
Cooked.
That is raw.
Natalie, I need a bass and I need it right now.
It needs, seriously, 8 minutes.
8 minutes?
I didn't have anything. Nothing was done. I have to do these from start to finish.
Krupa definitely left me in, like, this shithole. Like, no fish seasoned, nothing.
You really ate out?
Yes, really.
Shit.
How long, Natalie?
7 minutes.
There were one too many bumps for my fucking liking. One too many bumps.
I'm being honest with you. That's what I need. I'll have the next ticket with the bass in a minute afterwards.
There was nothing done, Will.
It's now or never for Will right now. Let's do this.
As Will tries to get his team back on track over in the Blue Kitchen.
Just push hard. One strip, one bronzini. How long?
I got 1.5.
Beautiful.
Paul is driving his team to deliver the final entrees.
This is it. This is the biggest push. Be as a team. We are fucking blue.
We got
this. Ride or fucking die. Let's go.
Yes,
push,
yes,
push.
Let's go.
We can do this, baby. 30 seconds.
Push as hard as you guys can fucking do. I pitched you all for a reason. Prove it to yourselves that you can leave on a high note. Push to prove to Chef Ramsay why he shouldn't have kicked you out of here.
Service.
Passionate Paul has his team motivated and moving.
Branzino.
While back in the Red Kitchen,
behind fish,
Will's key move of placing Natalie on the fish station is paying off as hungry diners receive their entrees.
How's your steak?
Really good.
And it appears that both kitchens are totally hitting their stride.
Tommy, I need 3 New Yorks. I need them right now.
Coming right now.
Come on, guys. Let's move.
Come on. We're almost there.
Thank you.
How long on a fish?
I'm walking right now.
Oh.
Yeah,
I need one more New York, please. That's it.
Come on, guys.
This is my last table. Come on.
Dinner service tonight was the hardest dinner service that I have ever done in my entire career.
Home stretch.
But I am the only person in Hell's Kitchen that got Elise and Carrie to work together.
That's it.
Polly, you owned it, baby. Delicious.
Thank you.
Good job. Well done. Good job.
Good job. I don't think I did.
I know I gave it my all. We fought the entire way through, and no matter what happens, I'm proud of myself.
First of all, on a personal note, I'd like to say a big, big thank you to all the chefs who returned. Really good job. Okay, Paul and Will, I want you to say goodbye to your brigades now, please. Thank you.
Thank you. No matter what happens, I thank every single one of you for everything you guys did for me tonight.
Jimmy Socks.
Thank you so much.
Okay, great. Okay.
Thank you.
Good luck, Polly.
Thank you.
Okay, both of you, good job. Seriously,
you,
the way you handled your brigades tonight was exemplary. And now I'm going to refer to these comment cards. I'm going to take every little detail of service in account. I'll call you when I have my decision.
I'm filled with so many emotions right now. I'm going back from day one, and I'm playing back in my mind every great service, every good service, and every bad service. I have a coin flip's chance of winning. And it sucks. It sucks being in this position of not knowing anything. Pacing?
Yes.
Can I pace with you?
Yes. I don't know what to do. It's like musical chairs waiting for the phone to ring. I am going to freak out. I want this fucking phone call. I want to go. I want to get this done with. The anxiety is killing me. Oh my God. My heart is fucking...
You look exactly how I feel right now.
As he considers all that happened this year and what happened tonight, Chef Ramsay is taking his time with this very important decision.
First name?
Will from North Jersey.
That is delicious.
Thanks, Chef.
Stop arguing and just put the food up. Really? I don't like to lose. Do not give up. I want everyone to push until the last ticket is out. Heard?
Heard.
Come on, man. Come on.
You, office.
Fuck, I'm tired of getting my ass kicked. He can't fucking cook. He can't get the fucking risotto out.
Paul, what is it, please?
It's a pan-roasted sea bass, Chef.
It's got finesse. Point goes to Blue Team. Congratulations.
Thank you, Chef.
We ride or fucking die. Let's go.
Yes,
push,
Chef.
Push.
Hello?
Thank you, Chef.
Let's go.
Okay. Choosing a winner was incredibly difficult. Will.
Chef.
You have been Hell's Kitchen's most consistent chef across the board. And there is no doubt that you belong in a kitchen.
Thank you, Chef. I appreciate that.
Paul.
Yes, Chef.
You've been one of the best chefs since you arrived in this competition. And your passion, young man, is undeniable.
Thank you, Chef.
Well done.
Thank you, Chef.
After much thought, I have reached a decision. So I'd like both of you to step up to your doors, please.
I want this so badly, I can barely compose my words. I've never wanted anything more. To win would be absolutely, absolutely life-altering.
This is it, man.
All I've been talking about for the last 5 years is how if I got into Hell's Kitchen, that was gonna win for my mom. And now I'm one decision away.
The chef whose door opens will become the winner of Hell's Kitchen and become the head chef at BLT Steak in New York City with a salary of $250,000. Will, place your hand carefully on top of the handle. Paul, place your hand very carefully on top of that handle. On the count of three and not before, I'd like you to turn the handle. Are you ready?
Yes, yes, Chef!
On the count of three. One. Two. Three.
A big deal. I'm so proud of you.
Come here, you. Good job. Come on.
Always
you did good.
Always did.
You know that was not your best service.
I know. It sucks. I'd much rather would have won. I didn't come out here for second. I came out here for first. But if I had to lose to anybody, man, I'm glad it was Paul. Come here, bro. Give me a fucking
hug. You fucking earned that. You keep your fucking head fucking
damn right.
All the fucking way.
Damn right.
All right.
Hell's Kitchen with a Paul! Good job! Great job!
If I had to win, I'm glad that I beat the best. I'd also like to thank my team tonight. We didn't do it for me, we did it for my mom.
There's so much emotion going through me. I mean, sad, I'm happy, I'm ecstatic. My mom's looking down on me right now. She knows what I've been through. She knows how hard I've worked. This is all for her. I mean, this is it.
Look at that.
I cannot be any more proud of you. Any more proud of you.
There's one lady up there, I'm telling you, it's the proudest mom in the world. Don't
she
you
is.
Ever forget that.
We'll never forget that.
Well done.
Thank you, Chef.
Good job.
I can't believe this, dude. I'm so proud of you, Paul.
I'm so proud of you, too.
Paul won tonight because he's probably the most passionate, determined chef to ever enter Hell's Kitchen. He will make a great head chef. Because his enthusiasm is contagious. I'm so proud to hand him over to BLT Steak in New York City.
This is the greatest achievement I have ever reached in my entire life. I am a big fucking deal.
Paul, from where?
From Fort Lauderdale.
Have your balls dropped, because your voice is very, very light.
Yeah, they're down there.
Terry, thank you for one night not having an argument with Elise.
I know, right?
What happened?
Hell froze over.
Yeah, hell froze over.
Can I buy something from a lady?
Focus on you, Tommy. Don't worry about your lady.
Right, yeah? Right.
Let her graduate from high school, then you can worry about the rest.
Okay. Really, man? Really?
Good job. Tommy, how was it?
I ended up going to get something for my lady.
Oh, really? How nice. Yeah. Where did you go? Toys R Us?
Hey, gee, I can't. It's not going to stop.
Baby Gap, how was it?
It's not going to stop, is it? So I go home.
Get out there and continue, right? Take this and run with it. Now, really go with it.
Yeah.
I mean, seriously, just stop being such a bitch.